Anderson Cooper 360. CNN, weeknights at 8 and 10 Eastern.
Keep him honest tonight. What do you think a repressive regime that guns down its own people deserves from the United States? Condemnation? Economic sanctions, perhaps? Even military action? How about $53 million in brand new U.S. weaponry instead? That's the answer when it comes to the Gulf state of Bahrain, and it's the striking headline tonight. But before we tell you more, take a look at how they've been using the weapons they already had. A warning, though, this is very ugly stuff. It begins with protesters marching, chanting the word peacefully, peacefully. Then, watch. That was back in February. Anti-government protesters being shot by American armed security forces. Just part of a government crackdown that grew global condemnation back then and continues to this day. Now, back in June, the Bahraini Crown Prince visited Washington, but his reassurances about reforms apparently weren't enough at the time for the White House, which issued this statement, quote, "The United States believes that the stability of Bahrain depends upon respect for the universal rights of the people of Bahrain, including the right to free speech and peaceful assembly, and a process of meaningful reform that is responsive to the aspirations of all." A week later, America's UN ambassador addressed the Human Rights Council, putting Bahrain on the same list of human rights violators as Iran, North Korea, and Syria. Yet the protests went on through the summer, and so did the harsh crackdown on the dissidents, most of them members of the minority Shia community. The New York Times, citing Human Rights Watchers, reporting more than 1,400 arrests, including doctors whose crime was treating the wounded, and as many as 3,600 workers, mainly Shiites, fired from their jobs for not supporting the government. Widespread reports of torture as well, and at least four people reported killed in custody. Yet just a few months after putting it on the same list as North Korea, listen to the change in tone.
In Bahrain, steps have been taken toward reform and accountability. We're pleased with that, but more is required. America is a close friend of Bahrain, and we will continue to call on the government and the main opposition bloc, the WEFOC, to pursue a meaningful dialogue that brings peaceful change that is responsive to the people.
That's President Obama at the UN last week. Tonight we're learning that the Pentagon is proposing to grant the sale to Bahrain of $53 million in missiles, night vision gear, and armored personnel carriers. Bahrain, you see, is an American ally home to the Navy's Fifth Fleet. And in case you're wondering about the progress being made there that the President spoke about and that the Bahrainis boast about, well, take a look at this from YouTube just a couple days ago. It's an SUV driven by police. It stops in front of a home and fires something. We can't tell if it is tear gas or bullets. You can hear the people inside screaming.
Yeah.